And why am I not mid-enable? Why can't I not hear myself? I don't hear myself at all. Which is weird. So let me check something here. Let's turn this up and that up and turn that up. And I just don't hear myself at all. Really sad. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Space Engineers. I am your host, the Anxiety Gamer, otherwise known as Rev8. And, yeah guys, so I'm just gonna start off right away by showing all these frickin' red dots on my screen, and one of them is getting extremely close, and it is known as the Pirate's Business Shipment, and I don't know what to do about it, and I'm a little bit concerned, so he might just pass by. Hopefully he doesn't pick up any of our signals and send our way some bad guys. So let's just cross our fingers that that's not what happens. So let me go over a couple of things real quick. So let's run over here real quick. Last episode we ended with my drill ship, and we had some problems, and I felt stupid after recording that and actually watching it. But it is what it is, right? You learn, you have errors, and you learn. So what I did was I changed the ship over to a hydrogen thruster ship, and it's sitting over behind me, but I don't want to show it to you quite yet because I need to tell you what's going on. I recorded a whole episode. It's about 45 minutes of me trying to figure out why my ship, my drill ship, would not dump inventory into this, all right? Not only did I get very frustrated and rage quit a couple times, and then I thought I figured out the reason, and I came back on and started recording again, and I was actually building something while we were recording, and just talking, basically, and it was a very boring episode. I basically tore my ship apart all the way down through the middle, and I started tearing this apart too because I needed some parts, and let's go in here. I'll show you what's changed on the inside. I'm surprised that I didn't get a big wolf of air. There it is. I thought we always got it on the outside. So let's do that. Close that. Oh, those doors were open. So that thing's probably... No, we're still good. So anyways, I ended up making all these black conveyors. These are all new. And I thought that maybe there was an issue with the conveyors not being connected to the cargo containers, and I moved the cargo containers because they were sitting on this block, and I thought, well, maybe they can't process and dump stuff by going through machines, but then I read on the internet that they can, and I was just really, really getting frustrated. And so I rage quit again. And basically was giving up. This thing is freaking close. Let's go outside real quick. Shut the doors. So anyways, what ended up happening was... Where's that? It's right there. Okay, I don't want to show you what's going on behind me because it's kind of a secret. Let's peek over the corner. Oh wow, he's like really close. Alright, so anyways, I'm going to see what happens if he comes in front of us. So what happened was I rage quit, and I didn't like what I recorded, and so I just blew it off, and actually got some damage here. All these pieces are new too, so I couldn't figure out for the life of me what was going on. I really couldn't. It was very frustrating. And then right before I went to bed, after I decided that I didn't want to process that video and record, I realized that the drill ships cannot drop parts through this, right? I put all my inventory inside of my drill ship and was trying to get it to pull it out and go into my cargo container. It's not a cargo ship, it's a drill ship. And drill ships can only drop what they process. So if ice or ores will only go through there, parts won't. Now, I think a grinding ship will, but the other ship won't. So it was just an idiot move. And so it did work the whole time. Actually, it worked fine. So anyways, where's that little guy at? Is he still? I think he warped out. Yeah, because I don't see him. Yeah, he's not out here anymore. I don't see him. I think he hightailed it. All right, cool. So we're still good. So anyways, let me show you what I did. So we built a base. It's upside down. This is the same base as we had before, but I went and finished it, added some color. There's some black and some blue, and there's some cargo containers in there. I tried to use this and fix this. I started putting some oxygen generators and stuff in there, and I have some batteries and some reactors in there, and those are getting charged up right now. So this is going to be our base for a while. This right here below me is our new drill ship. It's just the hydrogen version of what I had. So it's all hydrogen thrusters and everything's the same. Nothing's changed. It's still called the same thing. However, this is what I built. So this is my fighter, and I have this recorded if you guys want to see how I built it. I think I still have a majority of it. I erased a lot of my video, but I think I still have this part. So, it's hydrogen and ion thrusters, and it's got a couple big ion thrusters in the back, and these are hydrogen. So it's kind of a mixture of the two. I had to play around with how many hydrogen, how many ion thrusters I needed, because I wasn't getting very good stoppage. With the ion thruster, so I had to add more ion, but the hydrogen are basically for damper control, just when I get inside tight spaces. But I built this out of standard blocks, armored blocks, and I think that we might want to upgrade at least these front pieces, or these, because I'm afraid from what I've seen in other people's videos is that the pirates actually target the most important blocks of your ship. So these would be something that they would target, definitely the turret and definitely the batteries and stuff, so, and especially the camera. So that's my fighter ship. It's called the Cymbalta. It's on it's in my collections. If you go to the Steam Workshop, it's on there. I didn't do any description or anything about it, but I kind of like it because it looks kind of like the Batman symbol. That's kind of what I was going for. I wanted something to look like the Batmobile or the Bat-jip ship or whatever you call it. So that's what I did. So one of the things that we talked about last video was, though, I couldn't make ion thrusters unless we found platinum. Well, we found platinum. It's right there. It's actually, I searched all over the world for platinum, and the only place that I didn't go was like right outside of our little place here, and it's right over there. Now, I got a lot of it already, and I think we have something like, I don't know, a couple tens of thousands in our inventory right now. So we have enough to upgrade this ship, which is what I want to do. I want to make this ship a little bit bigger so that we could put some ion thrusters and the hydrogen thrusters in and use this to carry our other ships around, and then we're going to use this ship to get us to Mars, and that's our ultimate goal. I don't know how many episodes it's going to take us to get to Mars. I wanted to do a lot of stuff on here, but here's the deal. I have a couple people that want to play multiplayer, and so I've went ahead and invested in our own dedicated server for space engineers, and I put quite a bit of mods in it, but nothing that's going to make the game laggy. It might be laggy. The only thing that I've been testing it with Link, the killer, and the only time that you notice a lag is either when a ship warps in or someone dies and they have to respawn with a new ship. That's the only time that you actually feel it. So that's what we're gonna be doing. So I might like rush through this one just to get to Mars and then start the multiplayer one, and then we'll start all over. But I have kept all my, this is on my blueprints, this is on my blueprints, that one is not. And the only reason is I can build my own ship, you know, in the multiplayer. This was a good atmospheric ship. It got us off the planet. But there's a lot of things that I want to do, but I don't want to, like, do them right now and then have to redo everything on multiplayer. I'd rather just use the multiplayer as our season, so we might rush through this and get to Mars, and then we will start season two. So season one is kind of like the inaugural season. Look at that, we're almost getting into an eclipse. That would be really cool. So let's get started with what we wanted to do. So what I want to do this episode is actually I want to get our base ready, because what I want to do is I need to actually, what you know what we need to do though is I need to get closer to Mars, because there's not really that there's not a lot of ice out here. I know there's a lot of asteroids and I have it set to high, but there's not a lot of ice, and I need ice in order to fill up our hydrogen tanks. But I would like to, I think that one of these asteroids around here, these white ones, is actually a, I think that one right there is actually all ice. So we might be able to harvest that. So I want to put a couple big hydrogen tanks on this, and then we'll store that as our hydrogen, and then maybe get our ship updated. So what are we going to do this episode? We're going to grind down all these things. We're going to expand the ship, and then we will start our process of moving. We need to get a warp drive, so that's one thing that we need to do too. These things are starting to move closer to us too. That's kind of concerning. I don't want to fight anything. I really don't, because I'm not armored. Or not, I shouldn't say armored. I don't have any weapons, so we might have to invest in some weapons. So let's go back inside. Oh, there it is. Okay. That section. Whoops. Do that again. There we go. It looks like we might be low on ice, because typically this is all full green. Yeah, so let's just check. I thought I had put a crap load of ice in here, though. And I'm not seeing any ice. Okay, so we're probably going to have to go get ice anyways. So let's go in here into production, and I want to see... Or actually, let's just do this. Let's go to G, and let's type in warp. I want to see what it takes to get... Maybe they're not called warp drives. Maybe they're called jump drive. Okay, I'm sorry. So we need construction components, computers, detector components, gravity generator components. All right, what's it take to make a gravity generator component? Spherical generator, gravity generator. It's gravity generator components. So that would be inside this inventory. So production. Super conductor conduits, thruster components, motor detectors, large blocks, I guess. Let's go back through here. So let's look. Flight seat, nothing. I doubt that this is anything. There's the hard armor that we kind of need. Oh, here it is, right here. So we need silver, gold, cobalt, and iron. Silver, gold, cobalt, and iron. So what do we have? We have a little bit of gold. We have lots of silver. There's cobalt on our... There's cobalt inside of our asteroid. Silicone, lots of iron and nickel. I have a lot more platinum than that. It's processing it, so it's sitting down here. So we have 124,000 in gold. So we could go ahead and make a jump drive. I don't know how many we need. I think we only need one. So I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to grab a bunch of steel plates. And that's bulletproof glass. I don't really have a lot of steel plates, do I? No, I don't. So let's go ahead and grab all these. Let's put the uranium back in here. And let's go down here. There's some more steel plates. That's in the connector. That's all we have? Really? Okay, well, let's go to production. Let's make some steel plates then. So let's do like a couple hundred. All right, so let's do that. I'm going to do that real quick, guys. I'm going to start getting the ship kind of rearranged on the outside. I'm going to grind down those big thrusters, because those take a couple trips. And then we'll come back and get working. Be right back. All right, guys, so let me show you what I've got done so far. We've opened up the back of this ship. This is going to end up being the hangar bay that we're going to park our other ship inside. But as you can see, I got a lot of stuff in here that I got to move. And we are going to move it to a different location. But I started on this side. I already have the other side done. This is what I've been working on for, I don't know, about 2 hours or so. I don't want to play around with a bunch of blocks and weirdness, but basically all I did is I put these ion thrusters pointing forward and one hydrogen pointing forward. We're going to use the hydrogen as our stabilization. I got two hydrogens on the side. I put four ions on the bottom, and then I'm going to go ahead and put two more hydrogen thrusters on the top. We're going to remove those. Because I'm going to take the cockpit area, I'm going to put it on top of the ship, and we're going to kind of readjust the way that the ship looks. It should look pretty cool. And then on the back, I just put two large ion thrusters. Now, these take a crap load of thruster components, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. And I've just been doing this as I'm building. So if we go into production, I got one of them. What's it missing? What's it missing? We ran out of gold. All right. Is that what we're missing? So let's go in here. Silver, iron, nickel. Yeah, we ran out of gold, so I'm gonna have to go get some gold. The good thing is, I think one of these meteors, and I think we marked it, has gold on it. Let me see. That's nickel, magnesium, and iron. There is a gold one out there somewhere. I know where it's at. So I think it's actually that one right there. If you look at the little brownish area, I think that's actually gold. So we're going to have to get some gold. I'm not going to do that right now because that's going to bore you guys. But I just wanted to show you what I'm working on right now just to get this kind of put together. So I'm going to go ahead and start tearing. These are just conveyors. I need to dump some stuff off, so let's do that first. I'm just going to put stuff in this one for right now. This one's empty. So let's go ahead and put those in there and those in there. And I'm running out of energy pretty quickly, but we should be okay. So let's tear these apart. I'm not going to tear out the hydrogens just yet because they still have hydrogen in them. What I'll probably do is we will build the new hydrogen tanks at the front, and then we will do there's an option on here if you go down to the bottom, a stockpile, and basically what it'll do, it'll take everything out of this and pull it forward. So anytime you click on stockpile, that's what that'll do. It'll find where it, whatever it is that you're looking for, and it will pull it out as long as it's connected. So that's what we're going to do. So we'll do that. I need to get some more ice, though, because I'm running out of oxygen, actually. And I know I showed you that just a while ago, but that's becoming a thing. So we got those two torn apart, and those are the thrusters that are going to be in the bottom. These are all our gyroscopes. We're going to have to move those. We're going to have to move all of that stuff. And this is going to open up and allow us to have a really nice area in here. So I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to continue building this. And then when I get close to this being done, and I'm going to have to go mine some gold. So I got a lot of stuff to do in order to get this episode wrapped up. But I'm going to go do that. And then when we get back, we're actually going to move the cockpit. We'll play around with the cockpit area. And then I'll show you how to rehook everything up if that's interesting. But just trying to get some stuff put together, guys. I really want to go ahead and get to Mars. The more I think about it, the more I just want to get there. And so we can start the multiplayer, because I just don't want to do stuff so quickly back to back. So let me get my ship put together, and yeah, we'll be right back. All right, guys, so the joy of recording for you guys comes when I say we'll be right back in a couple minutes, and actually what happens is 2 days passes. But you'll never realize that when you watch my videos, because it seems like I just made a cut and I came back and we just kept on playing, but that's not how it really is. I don't know why. Every time I go over something, my guy turns. Look at that. Ain't that weird? Like he has no gravity. but I have gravity boots on. But what I say it is, I've been building for almost maybe a total of 10 hours. And I've exhausted all of the platinum off of that rock. And as you can see over there, our ship is completely different now. And the reason I had to change... I mean, that was a bad lag spike. The reason I had to change it... if you remember in the last segment, for me that was a couple days ago, I had a bunch of the ion thrusters, or I had two large ion thrusters on the back side of that fin right there, and we were going to put two large ion thrusters on that side. The problem with that is, if you go in and you look at what it takes to make an ion thruster, let's go in and look, let's type in ion, and you get one of these large ion thrusters, look over there on the right hand side down at the bottom. See the thruster components at 960? Now, if we go to... I don't think it will show components on here, but anyways, to make a thruster component, it takes a lot of platinum. And in the last segment, I was wondering, I thought I had a lot more platinum than I did on the ship. Well, it's because I used it all on these. There's three here, there's three there. We got the big ones on the back. And they got some over here, and I think there's a couple on the top. And what happened? There we go. Keep walking. And so that's why I ran out of... What is freaking going on? All right, there we go. That's why I ran out of plutonium. So I went back to our original concept of having the hydrogen thruster. So I just basically moved the hydrogen thruster over here to the side. I had to tear apart everything that I was building over here and redo it. But if you want to see what the guts look like, the same build over here, I left it open so you guys could see it. But basically, I have two very large hydrogen tanks connected to one thruster so that we don't lose, or we're not going to run out of any hydrogen, that's for sure. And then I have these oxygen generators to try to produce or keep up with the hydrogen demand. And that goes into the ship. I'm thinking about putting two more of these inside the ship because everything else I kept is, I just don't have any platinum left. So my whole idea about using ion thrusters is kind of going out the door. I have enough to finish this side right here to make it look like this side right here. But the rest of these are hydrogen. So I have hydrogen there. We added some more on the sides. But yeah, we completely reconfigured our ship. It's kind of, I don't know. You guys can tell me what you think about it, or we'll name it or something. I'm not going to keep it white. I just wanted it white so I could see it. It was black and it was kind of hard to see what I was doing. I did find out though that if you hold your four button like this, remember I said I was having hard, I knew you could paint the blocks without using that paint tool. My paint tool doesn't seem to work anymore. I don't know if there was an update to the game or something, but I can't get the mod to work, but maybe it's just something in the configs, or I don't know, it doesn't matter. But if you press P and you click on a color that you like, and you say okay, if you hold down your shift or you click your mouse button, it changes the block, see? Like that. Ain't that cool? Now if you hold your shift and then click your mouse button, it does a large area. So let's go back. Let's change this back to white. All right. And if I hold the... I just want to see because I don't know what the actual radius. Let's get that in big flat area. If I hold the shift and click the mouse button, it does that big of a section. So that is like... What is that? I had it right here. So that's a 7x7 area. Yeah, 7x7 area. And everything inside that block turns red. Ain't that cool? So that's a way that you can paint it. So let's go back to the white. So let's go do this. And I think we had it right there. Is that about right? Nothing inside still red? Nope. Good. So if I needed to paint this, I was thinking about painting these things here red. We'll probably do that. I haven't finished the bottom yet. I still have a lot to get done. I had to reconfigure all this. We're going to have to put some thrusters on the bottom because I don't have anything facing the bottom except for these ion thrusters right here. And I'm probably going to tear those apart because I don't have enough. I don't think I have enough to do four over there. I'll have to see. We have, I think, 300 and something left to use. So, yeah. So let's go in the back. I want to show you what we're going to do. We're gonna build something really fast, and I'll show you how it works. And that's probably going to be this episode. And then I'll continue to build this. But this used to be the area where all the hydrogen tanks were and all our workable stuff is. I left these slots out right here because that's what we're going to get ready to build. And I put a connector here in the middle. This is just going to be our hangar. And as you can probably figure out, that's going to be where we're going to put the hangar door. So we'll fly our ship into here and park. Now this is all going to be airtight. I'm missing a block over here. So let's go ahead and put a block. Oh, I need steel plate. I'm out steel plate. Anyways, we'll go get that. And I need to fix this. I was going in and out and I got tired of flying around to the outside. So I got air vents here so we can pressurize the thing. And then if we go through here, let's go ahead and lock this off. Yeah, let's go ahead. Can I press F? Why is that doing that? Oh, I gotta do the doors. That's right. Alright, oops. Let's do this. Get inside. Okay. So this isn't airtight yet because I have a hole in the thing. So we're gonna have to go in here before we get any airtightness. Like that. And then this vent should probably kick on. Can I take my helmet off? Nope, not yet. So it's not been filled up yet. So we're going to probably have to go into this air vent and see if that works. I probably don't have any oxygen left in my oxygen tanks. Ooh, that's going to be a problem. Let's go in here. Because I had to move everything. Let's go down here to oxygen tank. It's filled. So right now we want to set up our hangar doors. And so we need to go in and we need to get, let's do hangar. And I'm pretty sure it was the 1x3. One by three. Let's see if it was this one. I'm not quite sure. That's a small ship. Can I get the big ship version? No. So let's go back in the doors. And air type. Let's try that one. Yeah, that's it. Okay. So we need to rotate this. Why is this not working? Oh, because I need steel plate. I'm such an idiot. So let's put these in here. And they want to go like this. Now, they go down three blocks. And so that's why these are sunk in the floor. So it actually only goes down one, two blocks. And then this will come up one, two blocks. So we need to put all these in here. So we need to make sure we get the rotation the same on all of them. Why is it not letting me? Is it because I'm in the way? There we go. Rotate. Keep that one the same. That the same. That the same. That the same. That the same. And then we need to rotate these like that. Cool. Alright. So let's weld these up real quick. Okay. So let's see how much we can weld on any of these. Most of it's going to be the steel plate. So let me get these welded up and then we'll set up the buttons, and we'll probably put the buttons up here because we'll probably put two sets of buttons, a button up there and then some buttons down here. So let me get the stuff, we'll get this welded up, we'll be right back. Alright, so now what we need to do is make a thing called a button block. And if we go to G, come on, G, button. There it is right there. That's what we want. We want button panel. So let's go ahead and get that. Let's drag that down here. And let's put that up here. I don't know if we want to put it here or down there. You know what? Let's go ahead and put it downstairs. Because I typically, if I'm going to go in and out, I'm not going to like open it from up here and then walk all the way down here and then depressurize everything. And then, yeah. So let's do this. And we're going to lose just a little bit of oxygen. Oh, pajama on. Oh. All right, let's put this right here. Should we put it there, or should we put it like right here at the end of the... Yeah, let's put it right here. We'll put it... let's put it over here by the door. Yeah, that's better. Alright, so we'll put it right here by the door. And what's it? An interior plate. Oh, Jesus. You know what I need to do? I need to put a cargo container out there. Alright, so let's do this. Interior plate. What are we going to need for this thing if I had to put it down? We're going to need, we have everything. Cool. Shut the door. This has been one of the longest episodes. I bet when I edit this, it's going to be like an hour and a half long. Alright, cool. So, all these buttons are empty, okay? So you can, if I click on it, nothing happens. But if I go in here, and we go down here to the buttons, we got four buttons available. We wanted to set up actions, alright? So, we need to actually go into our inventory, our control panel, and grab all the airtight doors. So we need all of those. Hangar doors, yep. And we're going to name those hangar doors. Alright, save. And then we can go in here, like this, and then we can go into setup actions. And we can grab our groups, and we have hangar doors right here. So we can put this on here, and we can toggle this open. And then we can grab it again. And toggle this one closed, okay? And you can do that for all the buttons. We're gonna leave that on. Anyone can use, that's fine. Button name, let's see, hangar doors. It should probably say on there. It just says hangar doors. Hangar doors, let's see. Button one, let's name it, let's just name this hangar open. Okay, and then this one's going to be hangar closed. That should have saved that. Yep, okay, so we should be able to see that on here now. Hangar closed, hangar open. Okay, cool, so they're open now. So if we click this button right here, all you have to do is press F. It should shut the doors. Cool. And there we go. And these are airtight doors too, so if I had these vents on, we could pressurize the room, and then we could work out our stuff in here. So if I click this one, this will open the doors. How cool is that? Alright, so let's go do something. I want to see if it fits, because I don't know if it fits or not. So let's turn ourselves over. Let's go down here and jump in this. Let's unlock our landing gear. Let's turn on our thrusters. Alright, cool. Alright. Are we too big? Oh my gosh! Look at that. Oh my gosh, are we like barely... Oh no, we're fine. It's just the way that the camera looks. We do have to lower it a little bit, so let's go ahead and park in here. It does look a little scary though, doesn't it? Alright, let's go like this. Oh, it's not going to let me. Alright, let's just park it. There we go. I should have enough room to rotate it. Yeah, there we go. That's cool. Alright, so then we can back up. Cool. Alright, let's park it. Yep, and it locks in. Good. So we're locked in. So I can go. Do I? Nope, I don't. Okay. We'll have to set that up because I can refuel all our hydrogen tanks with that. That'd be cool. All right, so we are locked. And jumping out. Awesome. So there we go, guys. Hangar bay for our warship. And then I put a, just before we go, I put a connector here so that we can bring over our drill master. But I'm going to have to go get some more materials so I can finish up the ship. So next episode, guys, we are probably going to have a finished ship. And we are probably going to work on the warp drive. So I need to get some more materials for the warp drive. And then we will probably try to take a couple jumps. We might jump over to the moon first. And then we'll jump on over to Mars and get this little series wrapped up so we can start our multiplayer series. And we might also next episode put on some turrets on this thing because we're going to have to defend ourselves in case we jump into some baddies. So, yeah, guys. Right before we leave, look what else I found. If I type in W, look at this, watch this. I put this here. Turn around. Hold on. Watch this. Watch this, guys. Press number one. Hey. Well, that's not a wave. What kind of wave is that? That's like a wave saying, no way. I ain't going there. All right, whatever. All right, guys. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, make sure you hit the like button. If you're new to my channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. And I'll see you guys soon.